What is up, everybody? This is your Brooklyn neighborhood Big Mike here, bringing you some more Mafia 3. Picking up short of time where we left off, we are on the next missions and the next territory, which we are giving to Bert. And we also have another mission to kill a hitman who's going to try and kill us. So I'll probably be doing the missions first and then the hitman second. But before I get too far in this, don't forget to subscribe. I hope you enjoy. Let's get to it.
Still publishing that rag of yours.
If it bleeds, it leads. And with you out there doing what you're doing, Christ, can't print copies fast enough.
You have something for me?
Whores. You want high-end whores in the French Ward? You go to Handsome Harry Rubber Show. Lou Marcano's hand-picked man.
Probably a safe bet that Lou funnels all his VIPs Harry's way.
You like to fuck? Harry's the man you want to see. He's got it all covered. Hookers on the corner, porno shoots, and if you got the money, he'll let you live out your sickest fantasies.
Usually a good idea to cut off the big money first. Hurt an asshole like Harry right out of the gate.
I can see the headlines now. New Bordeaux's Blue Bloods cotton sex scandal. Or maybe the city's dark, perverted heart.
I'll see what kind of information I can get out of Harry's people about the operation. And the high rollers.
The fellas running horse for Handsome Harry will know what he's up to.
How you driving, man?
Coming through.
How
you doing?
Hey, watch
it. How you doing? Coming through.
Who do you think you're shoving?
Just to be letting up. What are you doing in this part of town?
I'm sick to death of this rain.
I hope that rain's done coming down.
Oh, pardon me.
Yeah.
tell me all about the Plowhouse.
The boss has some VIP customers coming in. Sick fuckers who like to hide the glass. I can tell you where they're gonna be.
You can thank me later.
It's a new plan. I'm going to have to kill Santiago so I can get on with the missions, because they keep screwing me over every time, every chance they get.
She said she got it from her brother.
How you doing?
I told her she was full of shit and walked right out.
Hello there.
This is trouble you don't want, boy.
Targets on me in the ward.
Of course. Be there soon.
You must be the Nigger.
My name is Lincoln Clay, motherfucker.
Nigger? Lincoln Clay? These things mean the same thing.
Some cash over for safekeeping. I'm in the French ward.
Hold your horses. I'll get to you.
Your money's
better not
always
lose this.
Safer on with me. Call me if you need me.
You don't have to worry about it.
Do I look worried? What about little Steve? How'd you handle him?
Told him he can't deal to the girls that have to.
Think what you're about to do.
Cassandra told me to reach out. I certainly appreciate some help with phones. The Plowhouse. How can I get to Harry?
Yeah, the boss is throwing a little fuck fest for the deep pocket types. There's supposed to be a lot of money at the door.
My crew will be in touch.
dead either?
Fucking just...
Secret's not in your eyes. Here comes a wolf.
I see him. There he is. Got him. Over here.
No way. A scare force like this.
Come at it. Leave. Spinning. Out of my way.
Lord, don't take me. I'm not ready.
Hit him from the other side.
And the French war need to kick me loose.
I'm in the French war.
Be there soon.
Find me. Is it clear now?
Hello. Does another hang on
better
before
not
you? On my way. Call me if you need me.
Excuse me. time is just as precious as y'all's.
We need some common ground.
Out of the way.
How rude.
That's funny.
Let's hope it doesn't go on too long.
Out of the way.
Watch where you're going.
Niggas in the mix are the most gullible.
Thank you.
hand some cash over for safekeeping. I'm in the French ward.
Hold your horses. I'll get to you.
Got something keep I can hang safe. On to for you? Bonsoir, chef.
TV? Who's got the money for...
So what? Just charge them extra, relax everything, and bite the pill.
Hey,
Hey there, man.
Oh, shit!
Once again.
When I find you!
That's making me uncomfortable here!
Come tussle with a motherfucker, yo.
Son of a hall.
Slip behind him!
There he is!
Found the man!
Whoa, there he is!
Woo, gonna put you down like a dog!
I'm not ready to die!
What happens next, motherfucker?
Think you know?
French War. Think I can stash a little dough?
Be there soon.
Hall insurance.
Got something I can hang
on
to for you?
Guess our business is done here.
Plugged in, but most? No.
Tell them
everybody get
grab
down.
Us some cover!
Don't look back. Just get the control. We're
getting shot up.
Got fucking deep.
Nobody's fault but yours.
third-party presidential candidate, George Wallace, is rising in the latest national poll. The pro-segregationist is now projected to take 19% of the vote. He believes there's no doubt he will win much of the Deep South, including Alabama, Mississippi, and our own great...
Sounds like Handsome Harry's a little agitated. Apparently even his clientele can't get their jollies while being shot at.
Is he back at the Plowhouse?
He prefers to call it on Beljardin after the flower shop it's attached to. But yeah, he's there. Probably wishing he had a tit he could cry into.
You a sick motherfucker, Carly, but thanks for the help.
Impression I get is that Handsome Harry might not be so handsome once you're done with him.
I need a supply run out to the French ward.
Be out directly.
Good. Clothes already down. Fucking rain. Wish it keep going.
Anything you want here?
Show me what you got.
I'll be... This is done. You know how to fight.
Got some targets lined up in the ward.
It's a bad time. Call later.
Someone could use it.
Got some targets lined up in the ward.
Of course. Be there soon.
I see him! There he is!
Good shit.
Fuck me, I'm bleeding!
Whatever you say, man. Whatever you say.
Smart man.
Tell me.
Get your man over to the French ward. I need backup to lock this down.
Okay, my friend. But don't be forgetting me for that next piece of real estate we acquire.
Coming through.
You could say excuse me.
Big Jim?
Detective Jim McCormick.
All right, Detective. I heard you have a problem with Marcano's drug operation in the French ward.
Boy, it's this whole city's problem. His man Doc Gaston's burrowed down like a fucking cockroach, pumping the whole city full of poison.
Where's Doc Gaston operate out of?
If I knew that, I'd have him in a cell. Biggest goddamn pusher in the city, and no one knows a fucking thing.
The name Sal Marcano tends to do that to people.
Fuck Sal Marcano. Best lead I've got is that one of Gaston's suppliers is coming to town. Gonna meet with one of Gaston's people. I can't get any closer, but your friend says you're good at getting information out of people.
I'll see what I can find out.
Don't be shy about knocking around some... of Doc Gaston's boys. Probably the only way to get him to talk.
Tell me about Doc Gaston's operation.
We got a fucking ton of shit coming in by boat. I'll tell you where.
Your ass belongs to me.
Feeling a little light, fellas. I'd have to fold after this one.
I'm in the French War. Think I could stash a little dough?
Sure thing, Cher. Heading your way now.
Got something I can hang on to for you?
Better not lose this.
Okay, I'm good to go.
Crazy, or did you catch that too?
Blinken, you don't miss me.
Let's tweak this boy wrong. He's over here, you bunch of fuckwits.
Blow his ass up.
Gotta hand some cash over for safekeeping. I'm in the French ward.
Sure thing, Cher. Heading your way now.
We're gonna take off your
hands. Keep this
safe. Guess our business is done here.
Hearing about a lot of dead dealers. The ones that are finally talking, saying Doc Gaston's in the system beneath the Big Mouth Jazz Club.
You're not gonna try to convince me to let you arrest him, are you?
If I wanted to arrest him, I wouldn't have let you be a part of this. Justice might be blind, but it shouldn't be stupid, too. Go do whatever it is you're gonna do.
Sure thing, detective.
You lured out that hippie asshole Gaston. You gonna go deal with him?
Run! Run!
There, you see him?
Oh, my God!
Oh, shit!
the other side.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Say goodnight to the asshole.
Before he was here.
Go back and look over there.
Only so many places to...
He's here! Fucking handle it!
Fucking freak.
Give me some of your men. We're locking down the French war.
All right, but if I'm securing the entire district for you, I expect you to follow through with me keeping it.
Capo, that's when he turned his sights on Sal Marcano.
Listen, it's like I said before. It's the same offer ran over in Vietnam. You want to bring down the dipshit in charge? You target their men and infrastructure. Eliminate their ability to fight back. And before they know it, they're standing there all alone, ass hanging out in the wind.
Gotta hand some cash over for safekeeping. I'm in the French ward.
Hold your horses. I'll get to you.
Need to make a deposit?
Better not lose this.
Going straight to the bank.
got a name for your judge. Cornelius Holden. He just made a call to Lou.
Not get worked up. I barely avoided that lunatic, Lou. Then I pay me enough, I'm gonna stop you right there, Cornelius. Never know who might be listening in. You need to get this shit under control here. Because until you do, your brother's case isn't going anywhere. There's no call for that kind of talk. I'll send over my car, a couple of my best men. They'll see to it that you're kept safe.
Cornelius is 60. The dipshits of this state first elected him to the Fifth Circuit in 1951. There's something else you should know. Those two men are Lamont Harris and Trey McCall. They were killed by a man named Hollis Dupree.
Yeah, I heard he gunned them down when they showed up to his house asking for help.
Hollis claims he was in self-defense, said he thought they were there to kill him. Cornelius is the judge that's put to trial.
So killing him might kick up a lot of noise.
Cornelius is an entitled southern asshole. Killing him is going to do a lot more than kick up some noise. Hopefully, it'll send a message that is long past the time that those cocksuckers went extinct. That's the car down there that Lou was talking about.
That thing armored?
I pulled the work order for it. It's a complete custom job. Tough as hell. It'll take a pounding, but it won't be impossible. Cornelius is scheduled to leave any time now, so this is your window.
You follow a set route?
Not since the trial started, but he still makes a stop or two on the way home. So, you can either hit him then, or go after him when he's driving around.
All right.
And watch out for the cops.
This nonsense right now. Post. What are you waiting for? Go! Go!
All units advised. Suspect located. On scene units engaged.
And watch out for the cops.
Just words. Killing him like that was...
is home in this state. What are you gonna do, Your Honor? See justice done. That's what.
Go ahead and drive. There's something I need to play for you. You want to hear Marcano tear Uncle Lou a new one?
Lou Marcano was bribing a district judge named Cornelius Holden, is that correct?
Sal Marcano spent a lot of money getting Holden in his pocket. A lot of money. Judges like that don't come cheap. And with Holden out of the picture, Sal had to find someone else to legalize gambling.
And that person was State Senator Walter Jacobs.
That's right.
You had one fucking job, Lou. Now it's to keep holding him one goddamn pistol after that room.
What was I supposed to do? He wouldn't listen, Sal. It ain't my fault.
Nothing's ever your goddamn fault. I swear, if you wasn't my brother, I'd clip you myself.
Now listen here. I know a guy. a state senator named Jacobs. He's on the Revenue and Fiscal Affairs Committee. Has a lot of influence.
Can we get to him?
Already have. He has a thing for fucking on women who ain't his wife.
I don't want to twist this guy's balls out of the gate, you understand? We need to be smart about this.
Yeah, of course. How about I throw him a fundraiser on the riverboat? Show him a real nice time. Get him laid. All that shit.
This goddamn casino got me tapped, you understand? This goes down to shit or we're fucked. All of us.
I'll pick the guests myself. Make sure they know what's what. Then we'll take a nice long cruise down the bayou. Get them all liquored up. Once he sees that payday, Jacobs is gonna do whatever we want.
Lou Marcano knew everyone. I mean, politicians, merchants, lawyers, bankers. He insisted on being called Uncle Lou and was basically the Santa Claus of the French Ward.
According to the police reports, Mr. Marcano and Mr. Jacobs were killed during a fundraiser on a riverboat.
Thing about the bayou is it's a very big place. You could blow the living shit out of everything in sight and no one would even notice.
Ready to go when you are.
Assume you already mapped out where the riverboat's gonna go.
Lou's pretty fastidious about that kind of thing. Always follows the same path when he goes cruising through the bayou. Doesn't want anything to happen to his beloved Delphine.
Gonna be the least of his problems. You recon the area?
There's an old coal dumper that they have to sail past. I've already got it rigged to blow. You just need to connect the primer cord to each block and then set it off. Detonator's down by your feet.
All right.
Isolate and kill. Lincoln Clay's specialty. What's wrong? Yeah, it's the boat thing, isn't it?
Not saying it is, not saying it ain't.
You need to get over it. You were on, what, 40, 45 PBRs in country?
52. That's not the point. You don't know what it's like to get onto a boat knowing full well the damn thing's gonna sink? Gets old, man.
Look, you blow the coal dumper. Boom. It hits the boat. Then you jump on board and kill Lou and those other assholes. 50-50, you don't even get wet.
50-50?
40-60, but still. .30-70 at the worst. Thank you.
something. Ain't nothing for you to worry about. Let's get you upstairs. You're all fan out. Watch the rest of the boat. This sure shit wasn't an accident.
Sure, keep your head down! damn it! Boys! Don't let nobody walk this ship, you hear me? The moment this is here, and I want him dead! Yeah!
Spoiled by this, Lou. Now, you...
No!
again.
Get over here!
Enough, you wop asshole!
What the fuck, Lou?
Take another step and he gets it. You think I give a shit about some politician?
Please! Please, I don't even know what's going on!
Kill me.
I don't want your money. I want you to send a message to your brother.
Yeah. Anything. Oh, just say it. Just say it.
Lord Almighty.
Explosion aboard a riverboat. Local businessman Louis Marcano also lost his life, along with dozens of other wealthy donors there to attend a political fundraiser.
When Lincoln left his gutted body on a statue commemorating Andrew Jackson, people were horrified. I mean, how could that be anything but a political statement?
Lincoln once told me he couldn't tell any other cheek. The world doesn't work that way. I spent the better part of 40 years trying to prove him wrong. But I was just lying to myself. Look at how we treat each other. Compassion is a sign of weakness, but greed is a virtue. The poor is considered morally corrupt while every excess of the powerful is celebrated. We sent kids off to die. For what? So someone can make a few bucks? Lincoln was right. He was always right. There ain't never gonna be another Dr. King or a Bobby Kennedy. But there always gonna be another Sal Marcano, another Sammy Robinson. the Lincoln Clay. We are cruel and wicked people.
Is it over?
There's no one left to stand in our way. We run this city now.
You're trying my goddamn patience, Lincoln. I don't come here to socialize and chat about politics. This is business. And outside of you asking me to lock down this goddamn territory, I'm not seeing hide nor hair of it.
Here's the thing, Lincoln. Getting you boys in here vying for turf is guaranteed to end up a pissing contest. Just easy on everybody if you give me the territory like you did last time.
This is all news to me, but if you still want to send it my way, I'll take it.
Take your time, lad. Wouldn't want to fuck up his lusp.
This one's all you, Bert.
I got big plans for this one, lad. And it starts with a statue of Marcano getting arse-fucked by a goddamn badger. Holy Christ, how the fuck did we make it through this shite in one piece? I thought for certain Scaletta'd have his throat slit by now.
It may not have all played out the way I would have liked.
But we're here, and we're making money. And Lord knows, I'm a hell of a lot better at being alive than I am at being dead.
I halfway figured Lincoln will have killed us all by now. What we done here? Taking the city away from Marcana and doing it without killing each other? We gotta be proud of that. I'll admit it. I had my doubts, but no more. You came through just as you promised. And I'm lucky to be a part of it.
Kinda thought I'd be gay to shit by now. So anything shy of that, and I'm good. Fuck. Fuck. You know how long I've been waiting for someone to stand up and be a man of his word? And in all my fucking days, you, Lincoln Clay, are the first motherfucker to do it. Thank you. You've done a hell of a job, Lincoln. Couldn't have done a better job myself. Probably.
We're living proof that the ways of Marcano, the lying, the backstabbing, the cheating, don't need to run in that direction. Those ways are as dead as he is.
Alright. Well, that is where I'm gonna cut this one off for today. That is where I'm gonna cut this one off for today. If you did enjoy, don't forget to subscribe. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna do the Father James talks and then I'll cut it off there.
At the time, I understood the pain Lincoln was in. Come home from war expecting peace. But in Lincoln's case, all he found was pain. Heartbreak. Ain't no way that doesn't drive you down into the muck and mire. Anyways, I was thinking, hoping really that if I could help him find a little closure, maybe we could shift his focus away from the Marcanos. See, he was in a coma when we laid Sammy and Ellis to rest, so he ain't never had a chance to say his goodbyes. Thought maybe if he did, he might see that he had a chance at a normal life. There never was a soul more wrong than I. I do not know him. I think us going to Sammy's like this is gonna do you a lot of good, Lincoln.
I'll be honest with you, Father. I hardly see the point in it.
It's a hard thing to let go, to say goodbye.
Saying goodbye won't give me what I want, Father.
Maybe what you want isn't what you need, son. Y'all. Lily called yesterday, checking up on you again. And she's setting her mind on doing something with Sammy's.
Can't hardly see what. The shape it's in and all.
Well, she's always been a woman of determination. Don't know if you recall, but after Perla passed, Sammy went to a dark place, buried a loss deep down. Started running girls out the back of the bar at all hours of the night. Finally, Lily had enough. She marched in with the fire of God inside of her, kicked all those girls out, customers, Sammy's crew. And boy, if she didn't lay into her brother like I've never seen. Told him he was doing wrong by Perla.
But more importantly, he was doing wrong by you boys, sending a message that their mother didn't matter. From that point on, there was no more prostitution in that place.
Huh. All I remember from that time is Aunt Lily swooping in and taking us to her place for a few nights. Getting ice cream and such.
She protected you boys. Family like that's a gift from God, son. It's all gone out front. You need to get on inside. Here's Anna and those men.
Dealt with. But if more come, I want y'all out of here.
One of my parishioners, she's out of town, has an apartment in Tickfaw. It's safe.
You don't know that.
I'll take her there. Meet me when you're ready.
All right. Gonna take a look around inside first.
Covered in blood. Covered.
Jesus. Who the fuck were those people? Should use my recon camera here.
One off this is like a DLC mission, and I kind of didn't want to do this until later on, but this one I'll do off camera or off video. So that's where I'm gonna cut this one off for today. If you did enjoy, don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell notification, make sure the rest of these Mafia 3 videos, also leave a like and a comment, I would greatly appreciate it. And that's about it. Just hope you enjoyed, and I will catch y'all in the next one.